बायोलॉजी चैप्टर 9 बायोमॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ क्लास 11। मॉलिक्यूलर वेट ऑफ बायो माइक्रोमॉलिक्यूल्स माइक्रोमॉलिक्यूल्स और बायोमॉलिक्यूल्स फाउंड इन द एसिड सॉल्युबल पूल रेंजेस फ्रॉम 18 to 800 डाल्टन। द एसिड सॉल्युबल पूल रिप्रेजेंट द साइटोप्लाज्मिक कंपोजिशंस। बायो माइक्रोमॉलिक्यूल्स इंक्लूड्स एमिनो एसिड्स लिपिड्स शुगर्स एंड नाइट्रोजन बेसेस। Biomolecules. Various form of living organisms is seen in our biosphere. All living organisms are formed by similar type of elements or chemicals. If we perform elemental analysis on a plant tissue, animal tissue or a microbial paste, we obtain a list of elements like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and several others and their respective content per unit mass of a living tissue. If the same analysis is performed on a piece of earth crust as an example of non-living matter, we obtain a similar list. All the elements present in a sample of earth crust are also present in a sample of living tissue. However, the relative abundance of carbon and hydrogen with respect to other elements is higher in any living organism than in earth crust. Biomolecules are chemical compounds found in living organisms. They include organic and inorganic compounds. Inorganic compounds such as minerals, gases, and water, while organic compounds such as carbohydrate, lipids, amino acids, proteins, enzymes. Analysis of chemical composition in a tissue. To understand type of organic compound found in living organism, one has to perform a chemical analysis. Take any living tissue, a vegetable or a piece of liver and grind it in trichloroacetic acid. Using a mortar and pestle, we obtain a thick slurry. It is strained through a cheesecloth or cloth cotton. We would obtain two fractions. One is called the filtrate or acid soluble pool and the second the retentate or the acid insoluble fraction. Thousands of organic compounds are found in acid soluble pool. For analysis of chemical composition, extraction of compounds is done. Then the extraction is subjected to various separation techniques till one has separated a compound from all other compounds. In other words, isolation and purification of compound is done. Analytical techniques, when applied to the compound, gives us an idea of molecular formula and the probable structure of the compound. All the carbon compound that we get from living tissue can be called biomolecules. However, living organisms have also got inorganic elements and compounds in them. How do we know these? A slightly different but destructive experiment has to be done. One weights a small amount of living tissue, say a leaf or liver, and this is called weight, and dry it. All the water evaporates. Acid soluble pool contains biomicromolecules. Molecular weight is less than 1000 Dalton. While acid insoluble fraction contains biomicromolecules, molecular weight is greater than 1000 Dalton. The remaining material gives dry weight. Now, if the tissue is fully burnt, all the carbon compounds are oxidized to gases form carbon dioxide, water vapor and are removed. What is remaining is called ash. This ash contains inorganic elements like calcium, magnesium, etc. Inorganic compounds like sulfate, phosphate, etc. are also seen in the acid-soluble fraction. Therefore, element analysis gives elemental composition of living tissue in the form of hydrogen, oxygen, chlorine, carbon, etc. While analysis for compounds gives an idea of kinds of organic and inorganic constituent present in living tissue. From a chemistry point of view, one can identify fractional group like aldehyde, ketone, aromatic compounds, etc. But from biological point of view, we shall classify them into amino acids, nucleotide bases, fatty acids, etc. The ash contain inorganic elements, calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium, etc. And inorganic compounds such as sulfur dioxide, potassium dioxide, sodium chloride, calcium carbonate, etc. Here is a comparison of elements in non-living and living matter. Elements such as hydrogen, they are weighted in earth crust 0.14%, while in human body it is 0.5. Carbon in earth crust 0.03, while in human body 18.5. Oxygen 46.6 in earth crust and 65 in human body. Nitrogen is very little in earth crust, while it is 3.3 into human body. Sulfur 0.03 in earth crust, while 0.3 in human body. Sodium 2.8 in earth crust and 0.2 in human body. Calcium in earth crust 3.6, while in human body 1.5. Magnesium 2.1 in earth crust, while 0.1 in human body. And silicon is greatest or highest in earth crust, that is 27.7, while in human body it is negligible. Biomicromolecules. Amino acids. Amino acids are organic compound containing an amino group and acidic group as substituent on the same carbon, that is alpha carbon. Hence they are called alpha amino acids. There are four substituent groups occupying the four valency position. These are hydrogen, carboxyl group, amino group and variable group designated as R group. They are substituted methanes. The R group in these proteinaceous amino acids could be a hydrogen amino acid glycine, a methyl group alanine, and hydroxyl methyl serine, etc. The chemical and physical properties of amino acid are essentially of the amino, carboxyl, and R functional groups. Here is the amino acid structure, in which R is equal to H in glycine, R is equal to CH3 in alanine, and R is equal to CH2OH in serine. Based on number of amino and carboxyl group, there are acids, for example glutamic acid, bases, lysine and neutral valine amino acids. Similarly, there are aromatic amino acids, tyrosine, phenylalanine, tryptophans. A particular property of amino acid are as follows. 20 type of amino acids are used in protein synthesis. Amino acids can be also be classified as follows. Essential amino acids, they cannot be synthesized by the body and should be supplied through diet. For example, lysine, leucine, isoleucine, tryptophans, etc. While non-essential amino acids are, they can be synthesized by the body. For example, glycine, alanine, serine, arginine, etc. A particular property of amino acid is the ionizable nature of NH2 and COOH group. Hence, in solution of different pH, the structure of amino acids changes. If both NH2 and COOH are ionized, it is called Zwitter ion. Here is the structure of the Zwitter ion formation. When two amino acids are connected, they form the sweeter iron. Biomicromolecules.